Hi, everyone. We'd like to welcome you to Real Talk. We're here at East Lawrence High School, and this is the day that we're going to highlight school custodians. They do so much great work for our kids and our community, and we're glad to be here today. We've got the athletic director and assistant principal, Mr. Joel Watson, here with us. Hi, sir.
Good morning. Glad to have TV 35 here, and we always enjoy getting covered as much as we can by TV 35 and whatever it is you guys are wanting. We're here to show just a little bit about what our custodians do on a daily basis. And again, we're glad to have y'all here, Ms. Pat.
We're glad to be here. And, you know, a lot of professions sometimes go unnoticed. But as you walk the halls, you see these custodians, you see their smiles, you see the work that they do. And we definitely want to highlight that today. So we want you to talk a little bit about that, if you would, Coach.
Oh, I'd be glad to. It is a thankless job. It's a job that always gets done, and our custodians do a good job with it. And, you know, every morning we come into a clean school every day. They're working as hard as anybody around here. We call them our unsung heroes. Absolutely. We've got a lot of them around the school, and we've got five real good ones that we'll show you today and let you help them. And you'll see just exactly what these custodians do on a daily basis.
Absolutely.
And again, we're proud of everything they do. Mm-hmm. And listen, they don't get thanked enough, not only by me, but by everybody. But, you know, they just do so much behind the scenes that nobody even knows it gets done or don't even realize who does it or how it gets done. But we're very fortunate that we've got some very good ones, and you'll see that today on today's show.
Absolutely. We're looking forward to it. You know, you're right. It is a thankless job because, you know, every time we walk into, you know, this school and on your campus, the floor is always shining. We don't see, you know, I can even look at the glass and see how clean the glasses are.
There you go. We've got certain jobs for certain custodians, and they'll talk about that as the show goes on. But Mr. Charles, he's our floor man, and he works, he does some specific areas. His main job is on the floors, and you'll probably talk to him about that since he's specifically responsible for all of our floors and our carpets in the classroom. But and Miss Gloria, she does most of the glass work, but like you said, but they all do a good job. They all do a good job. But each custodian is responsible for a certain area, and they'll talk about that when we get working here in a few minutes.
Absolutely, and you know that's what makes it a team. You know, because you have to have that type of partnership and that kind of teamwork, and to have specific areas of concentration.
You do. There's, you know, every classroom you have you know, certain things, like in the science rooms, they're a little bit different. We have requirements. We have to clean certain areas in the science rooms than we do a normal classroom.
Right.
So there are certain specific things that you have to do in certain areas of the school that they're responsible for taking care of.
And, you know, not just keeping the school clean. They have to have the type personality because they are around kids.
They are around kids. I think of one friend back, Mr. Daniel Burley. He was here when I first was hired years ago. Unfortunately, he's gone on. He's passed on. But he was a guy that took pride in his job.
Right.
Matter of fact, we'll look at a picture over on the wall in a few minutes ago, and I think about him all the time because he was what I think of in a custodian. He was always doing what he was supposed to do, how he was supposed to do it. Wasn't looking for ways or reasons why not to do it. He he went above, beyond. And these custodians do that. But Mr. Daniel Burley, he was one of the first custodians I met and was around, and I learned a lot when I was just a teacher around some of the things. I mean, you know, as administrators, you have to be a Joe athlete, you know, a jack of all trades. You know, it's not just the teaching end and the coaching end, but it's the building and the facilities and the maintenance of is just as important as anything, having a safe, clean building.
You're absolutely right. And you also have a scholarship named after Burley.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
After Mr. Burley passed on, there was a group of folks in the community. If I start naming names, I'm sorry, I'll leave somebody out.
Right.
But they wanted to do something special in his name. And every year we have the Daniel Burley Senior Picnic, where a group of folks get together and feed the seniors. And at the end of the year, we give out the Daniel Burley scholarship to some lucky male or female in the in the school that portrays hard work and dedication toward the school and the school building.
Absolutely. That's such an honor. And no matter what your job is, you have to operate with the spirit of excellence.
There you go.
All right. Well, we thank you so much, Coach, and we're definitely looking forward to meeting the custodians. And I'm ready to get my hands dirty a little bit.
Well, I told you to wear your working clothes. I told my custodians, I said, listen, she don't want to just, even though she's pretty, she don't want to just walk around and look pretty. She wants to walk around and work and get dirty. So we're going to let you do that, and I'll be around because I want to pick at you a little bit.
But I'm cool with that.
Again, I just want to say everybody out there in the community, you know, we have a fine custodial staff here. I wouldn't trade any of them for anything, and hopefully you'll see some good things today.
Absolutely, and I'm about to do it, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks.
Coach Watson.
Hello, Middle Georgia. Graham Slater for Dublin Ford Lincoln. Going to give you a sneak preview of our plans for our new dealership. We're investing heavily in this community because you've made us number one. We're going to have a state-of-the-art facility that is just going to just blow the competition away. We're going to have all the up-to-date electronic equipment, diagnostics, any tools that the salespeople or the technicians need, we're going to have. It's going to be a beautiful facility on Highway 80 West. As you can see, there is some progress. We've already got the site work done. The curbs are in, getting ready to pave. And, of course, the old building's coming down. But you come see us here at our old location. We're moving cars as fast as we can, get them out of here, and get ready for our move. But come and see the new dealership on Highway 80 West or come visit us at our current location for a great deal on a new Ford.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're here with Mr. Gregory Tucker. This familiar face here, I think I've ridden the bus with you.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Well, listen, talk to us a little bit about yourself and tell us what your areas of responsibility are here.
Okay. I've been here 10 years with East Lawrence High School. I started first at East Lawrence Primary, and I worked my way back down to East Lawrence Elementary, then worked East Lawrence Middle. So I'm home now in East Lawrence High School.
Home here in the high school.
Home in the high school. I really enjoy it. My job titles are, I work at the 100 Hall Extension, and I have about 10, 12 classrooms that I have to keep clean every day, keep the restrooms clean, make sure everything's clean for the kids. I comes in early in the morning between 5:30 every morning, make sure everything good and fresh when everybody comes in.
So you come in for this job before you do the bus route?
That's correct.
And you have 10 classrooms?
Yes, ma'am.
How long does it take you to have all of this done and then get back to your bus route? Because, I mean, being dual-hatted like that, you have to be on a time crunch and a good schedule.
Yes, ma'am. It takes about a couple hours.
But
what we usually do is do half in the mornings, you know, before the bus route, and after the bus route coming, I finish up the other half.
Very good. Now, and so you've been doing this for a minute. How has the transition been for you being around the little kids and then the teenagers?
It's really different, you know, with the babies up there with the primary school. It's more work with the primary school because
they make bigger messes.
They make bigger messes. The high school, they make a little mess, but now it's more as the babies are there.
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. And so in this position, how is it for you as far as your relationship with the kids? Because you see these students day in and day out, not just on the bus route, but just interacting with them with the work that you do here within the school.
Oh, a real good relationship with the kids. Most every kid in this high school know me. A lot of them call me about Mr. Greg and Mr. Tucker. And a lot of times the kids be having problems. I be down my hall working. They call Mr. Greg and we talk for a minute. And we talk. I'm just like a father to them. Yes, ma'am.
I was going to ask you that because it's more to it than just being a custodian and being the bus driver, because you do have to, in a way, kind of minister to these kids because they come to you with different issues.
Yes,
which,
ma'am.
Which is pretty cool that they have that kind of respect for you.
That's right.
Now, what do you think is definitely required other than being able to multitask? We talk about, you know, about multitasking. What do you think is a really good character to have working in your line of, doing your line of work?
Well, a real good character to have, you got to have a positive attitude at all times. You got to stay focused. You never know what's going to happen in between times that you are actually doing your job. So you might get stopped in the middle of your job and have to go do another job to help another coworker out.
Right. Okay. Well, listen, we want you to kind of show me a few things and let me do a little work with you on this 100 hall.
Okay. Okay.
You cool with it?
We cool with it.
And I don't mind working. regardless of what my family thinks.
I know you'll do a good job.
All right, all right. Thank you. Mr. Tucker, everyone. We're here with Mr. Sam Wright. How are you doing, Mr. Sam?
Fine.
Now, listen, we want you to tell us a little bit about yourself and talk to us about the work that you do here at East Lawrence High School.
Well, I worked the 100 hall.
Mm-hmm.
And
how long have you been here, Mr. Sam?
I say about 8 years.
Mm-hmm. And so what were you doing before you were doing this line of work?
I was working with the Millwrights.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. That's a site company out of Statesboro.
Out in Statesboro. So now here you are. You've been working with these kids and doing a great job here. How is it for you interacting with these young ones?
Well, I just enjoy it. I first said I wasn't going to do nothing. But when I retired, I could just sit around after I had to do something.
And so you're around here, you're around these kids every day. And tell us about the teamwork that you have with the other custodians.
It gets a little rough sometimes, but you have to get rough with them.
You have to get rough with them, Mr. Sam?
Yes, ma'am. I have to get rough with them.
Now, do you have a problem getting rough with them?
Not really. But that never. He's my problem.
Is that right? You know, so.
And that never right back down. He's my problem.
So you're pointing out all the ones that are the problems. So you're getting all that out of the way.
Out the way.
Now, listen, Mr. Sam, I want to do some work with you today. So what specifically are you in charge of?
To vacuum my room.
So you're vacuuming. Now, do you have a vacuum cleaner that I can use today?
It's on my buggy right now.
It's on your buggy. Are you going to work me too hard, or are you just going to be easy with me?
I'm going to be easy with you. I don't want you to work real hard.
Okay, Mr. Sam. All right, well, we look forward to it, and we appreciate you and everything that you do here. And we're glad you came out of retirement, at least for a little while. Mr. Sam Wright, everyone. We're here with Mr. James Waldrop, and you know, before we actually started talking, I was admiring his T-shirt. I love my wife. Did she force you to wear that, or is that part of your attire often?
That's just how much I love her.
How sweet is that? How long have you been married?
44 years.
44 years, and you still have the T-shirt to prove it.
Yes, sir.
Tell us a little bit about yourself, Mr. Waldrop.
I am James Waldrop. I worked at Forceman for 40 years,
mm-hmm.
and I worked with Mr. Dill's daddy. He was my overseer,
mm-hmm.
at the mill,
mm-hmm.
and my son, he was my boss man out here for a while, about 5 years.
How was that with having your son as your boss man?
Well, it was okay. I probably got away with a lot. The rest of them didn't get away with it.
I wonder why. You were probably sitting over there drinking some iced tea, and he just looked at you and said, "Look at old daddy over there."
No, we got along real good. Real good.
And
whatever he told me to do, that's what I done. Didn't argue with him because he was the boss.
I bet that made you proud.
Yes, sir. I'm proud of him.
And he's also now, where is he?
Southwest Lawrence.
Very good. Very good. Now, let's talk about what you do here, Mr. Waldrop.
I work down the 200 hall. I clean the classrooms down that way. I clean the gym and the lobby down there at the gym. I had to go down to the field house and clean it.
Now, those are huge areas.
Yes, ma'am.
Huge areas. And so what are your, as far as mainly with the floors always look nice?
We try.
And how long have you been here?
Going on my 10th year.
Going on your 10th year. So you were at Forceman for a very long time. You must have worked with my sister, Bernice Nelson.
Probably.
Probably did. A lot of great people coming out of Forceman. And so how's your interaction with the kids? Because we talk about how important it is, not just for the work that you do, but to have that type of relationship as far as with the kids here.
Well, some of them is real nice. Mm-hmm. Real nice. And some of them, they kind of hard to get along with sometimes.
Well, you know, that's teenagers.
Yeah, but they do real good.
Yeah.
They do real good.
And so do you enjoy what you're doing?
Yeah, I enjoy the mill better than I do on him.
You know, those are two different kinds of work, aren't they?
Yeah, I work with mechanical mostly, and it's just different.
It is different.
Yeah.
But the atmosphere, it's a good atmosphere.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh,
every
yeah,
time I see you, you're smiling going down the hall.
Well, you have to.
Yeah.
You have to.
And, you know, we were talking earlier where one of the custodians was talking about it's important to have a good attitude.
Right. Right. If you don't love your job, it makes it hard to come to work every morning.
Mm-hmm.
So I love my job, really. I really love it.
Very good. And that shows. That shows. And so what are you and I going to work on today?
Well, we can mop some bathrooms.
Mm-hmm.
We can clean commodes.
Clean commodes. Now, are you going to have gloves for me, or do you have a special machine?
We got a brush clean bit.
Okay.
We got a brush clean.
Don't give me one that's too tough now. I hate to have to run off camera.
No, most of them are already clean.
Okay.
I keep them clean.
Oh, yeah. I've been in your bathroom, so we know you keep them clean. All right, so we're going to do some stuff, you and I, a little bit later. We're going to hang out.
Okay.
Do you have suspenders for me?
No. I could have brought you a pair.
You could have brought me a pair.
Yes,
you
ma'am.
Could have.
Yes,
all right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Mr. Waldrop, and we'll be back in a moment.
Okay.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Freeman's Lawn and Garden, your local steel dealer, invites you in today to see the number one selling brand of gasoline-powered handheld outdoor power equipment in America for homeowners and professional landscapers. Check out the Steel PG55 handheld blower, Steel's FS45 string trimmer, and the multitasking combi system. Now on display at Freeman's Lawn and Garden, 1325 North Jefferson Street in Dublin. Call 272-2198. Freeman's Lawn and Garden, your local steel dealer.
All right, we've got Mr. Charles Wells here. Hi, Mr. Charles.
How are you doing?
Doing very well. Now, we're excited to be here, excited to talk to you all about the work that you do here, and definitely want the people to see just how important what you do is here. And, you know, I want to say this, too, not just at East Lawrence, but all of the schools. We appreciate everything that the custodians do, and we really want the people out there just to understand just how much work you do. So we'll start with you telling us a little bit about yourself, Mr. Charles.
Okay, my name is Charles Wells. I've been here probably 14, 15 years, and I'm the floor man.
You're the floor man.
Yes.
So you're the reason why these floors are so buff and so clean.
Well, yes. and it's a hard job.
It's a hard job, yeah, especially with all the traffic.
Right. Very hard.
I'm the type that after I mop or do something to the floor, I don't want anybody walking on it.
Well, you can't work here then.
I know.
Yeah, it'll be hard to work here then.
It would be.
Yeah, because the children, they going to walk.
They're going to walk.
I don't care if you have your sign down, whatever you have down.
Even when you put the signs down?
Yeah, they coming through.
But that's part of the job.
Yes, that's part of the job, because if it weren't for them, I wouldn't have a job.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. What?
But I had to learn that.
You did?
Yeah.
How long did it take for you to kind of realize that?
Ooh, probably at least 6 or 7 years.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. But then after I realized that we can't do without the children.
Mm-hmm.
We got to have the children to have the job, because if they don't make a mess, we ain't going to have no job.
That's right. And well, teenagers tend to make messes.
That's right.
I've got
That's
three right. of them to prove
yeah.
it. And two of them in this school.
Okay.
Now, what were you doing before you were doing this line of work?
Well, you know, I do hair.
Really? You're a stylist?
You know Linda Wells?
Linda Wells.
Yeah.
And who is that to you?
That's my wife.
Get out of here.
She been doing that probably 35 years.
35 years. Linda, he's shouting out to you, okay? Miss Linda Wells.
She probably done did some of your people.
Some of my people. She probably has.
I know she has.
She probably has. Now, let's talk about, now, what are you going to show us today that we're going to be working with you with?
In the lunchroom, because I work in the lunchroom too, the floors. So I'll let you run the scrubber.
Run the scrubber. Was that the thing where you hold with two hands?
No, it's one you walk behind, you mash it, and it'll go by itself, and you scrub the floor with, like, mop the floor.
Yes. Now, the lunchroom, is that kind of messy? Do they, like, do you have food all over the floor? They don't have food fights, do they?
Sometimes.
Are you serious?
Yes, ma'am. Sometimes. Sometimes they do.
Well, that definitely makes you work even harder, doesn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. All right. So we're going to get to see some of that and really talk about some of the things that you do so that we can see get a hands-on perspective of why these floors look as good as they do.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Thanks, Mr. Charles.
No problem.
You know, I could not let the day go by without you all meeting this wonderful woman here, Gloria Parks. Gloria, I had to get a female in, and you know that. I know you're not feeling well, but we definitely wanted to make sure that the people out there saw your face and just knew how great a job that you do here at East Lawrence. Okay. So why don't you, could you just tell them a little bit about yourself?
Oh, my mouth.
You're okay. Oh, and just tell them how long have you been here. Tell us that.
My name first.
Yes, your name
first. I am Gloria Parks. I work for the Lawrence County Board of Education for 14 years.
14 years.
14 years.
Have you been here the whole time, Gloria?
The whole time of 2000.
From 2000. And look at me, Gloria. Every time I see you, don't you know I light up when I see you?
Yeah, you do. But I got to light up myself first. And I just don't be ready.
Exactly. Okay. Does it take some time? You've been here for a long time working with these kids, and I can definitely tell that you get joy in that.
Yes.
How is that for you, Gloria?
It's fun. It's wonderful. And I love it.
And you can tell.
Yeah.
Every time I see you, I would give you hugs. And I'm like, I love this woman right here. I do. And, you know, when we have been talking to some of the other custodians about how important it is to have a good personality and to really love what you do.
Yes.
How's your relationship with the kids?
My relationship with the kids is just like I'm a parent to all the kids out here. And they just love me so that they just keep coming to me, asking me all kind of questions.
Is that right?
And I think I get a point to most of the kids. So they come back and ask me, say, Miss Parks, I need to talk to you. I said, well, okay, let's go sit down and let's go talk about this conversation.
And you know what? That is huge, especially when you're talking about teenagers.
Yeah.
When they develop that level of trust with you, that's something that you should not take
lightly. That's true. That's true. Because you don't never know what a child going through. So that's why you got to sit down and talk with them to make sure everything is going well.
And, you know, even when these kids graduate, they'll remember you.
That's right. That's true. They always, Miss Paul, are you coming to my graduation? I think about it.
And see, and they know you're funny,
yes,
too. They know that you will cut up with them.
Yes.
They know that you will give them straight talk. And that's very important.
That's right.
I can remember when I was a kid, I still remember my janitor. I remember how he would treat me. I would walk down the hall. I was little. And I remember how kind he was to me. And I would always look for that smile. I'd get off the bus, and I'd look for that smile.
I know, because Miss O'Neill would say, look at her with a smiling self.
You know what?
Yes.
And that's good. And I know you didn't want to be on camera.
No, I didn't, because my throat is about to, it's, we're going to talk about it.
So we appreciate,
okay,
you not feeling well, but still agreeing
all
to come up here so that they can meet you.
Okay.
Because I want you to know that I personally appreciate you for just everything you do. And we here at TV35 definitely are appreciative in the community. So what are you responsible for here? What is your area of...
Mainly, I do just about everything, just about what they do, except for the cafeteria.
Okay. So I would like to go along with you a little bit to see what you do.
Okay.
And I'm not afraid to get my hands dirty.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
All right.
All right.
This is Gloria, everyone, and she is definitely lovely.
All right.
Thank you
very much. All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Salvation Army Family Store is located at 1617 Telfair Street in Dublin, Georgia. We have all kind of great items in our store. We've got clothes, we have gowns, we have ties, we have shoes, furniture, mattresses, household goods, just about anything you can imagine we have. And on top of that, our prices are super low. Just about anybody can afford the things that we have in our store. We're also looking for donations. We need your items so we can continue to help the community. If it's too big for you to bring, then give us a call at 478-275-7336 and we'll arrange to come pick it up. The Salvation Army is a community organization that we help people with clothing and food items. We help with furniture and rent assistance. We help during disaster times. We help with just about anything we can. We take the proceeds from the sale of our store and we use that money in our programs here in Dublin and Lawrence County. The Salvation Army Family Store, 1617 Telfair Street, Dublin, Georgia.
This is it. I've got my gloves on, and I'm getting ready to get started here. Mr. Greg and I are going to do some bathroom cleanup work, and I'm ready. I'm not nervous. How are y'all doing over there? Today, of course, is part of Spirit Week, and these are some cool nerds that you're going to see. Nerds or preppies, ladies and gentlemen. I might as well get up in here with them. It's so much fun to see these kids. And, of course, with Spirit Week, it's Nerds or Preppy Day. And you see these guys are going full out. This is homecoming week. All right. Now, Mr. Greg and I, now you've already started without me. Is that right?
No, ma'am. I'm just prepping.
Okay. You're prepping.
I'm prepping.
Are you still prepping right now?
No,
we're about to get started. Okay. Now, what are you, talk to us. What are we about to do?
Mm-hmm. Okay, this is our Calvac machine, and it cleanses our restrooms. And what we're doing now is go ahead and get all the cords and everything prepped.
So this will clean a toilet?
It will clean a toilet.
I don't need a toilet bowl scrubber.
That's old school.
Old school. This is new school. Okay, very good. And so you're plugging it up. So what's inside of this thing? Is there some type of liquid or something you have in here?
Yes, that's a couple of chemicals, Calvac chemicals that we put in. We have to mix our clear water.
Uh-huh.
Clear water, and then we'll have to put our chemicals.
In here?
In here.
Okay.
In here.
Okay.
And that's more like our neutralizer. Our
sanitizer. A neutralizer. Okay.
That's our cleaner right there.
Very good.
And what the first thing we have to do, we have to make sure the machine has enough water.
Okay, you coming in? All right, let's go.
Okay.
All right.
The main key is just like a pressure washer.
Just like a pressure
washer. Just like a pressure washer. You won't mess up now.
Okay. Are we about to clean the toilet?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Oh, those are urinals.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. We want to make sure we have chemical A and B,
mm-hmm.
and A is for the bathroom cleaner.
Okay.
We also have another cleaner we use for staff infection, and mm-hmm. we use that more like for the gymnasium.
Okay.
Spread out for staff.
Okay.
We put on A for cleaning, and we turn on for pump.
Uh-huh. On this one? Okay, just press it. And that has the chemicals in it as well. I go underneath it. I don't even know what that is on the wall. That's something. All around here? All right. How? So you're not touching anything?
We're not touching anything.
How often do you have to clean this? How often do you do this?
We do it every day.
Oh, once a day.
We used to have the old brush that we used to come in with a bucket and we used it to clean the kit, but now they got water sitting down and now you don't have to come in and do it.
Go to the next. Can you move this? Nothing.
Okay.
What about all this water? Is it going to drain?
There's something wrong.
All right, let me do that one. You already got that one?
Mm-hmm.
that stuff come off, or is that part?
It comes off.
Okay.
So what it's doing is all the year of all the year of all the plants and everything.
Oh, okay.
I know we work
time. Okay. Okay, now we just did some serious stuff that could have potentially been quite disgusting. But there was no hands involved in scrubbing the toilets and things like that. And so besides this, you're also a multitasker here. What other things do you do?
Also, I have Joel Watts and Coach Joel Watts. I have him along with the athletic direct department. I'm in charge of whenever we have our away games or athletic trips. I'm aware of making sure we have buses to go along all those trips.
Okay.
So I'm in charge of pulling all the buses, to get the newer buses and replacing with the older buses.
Right.
I'm also working along with what Daniel Burley done. Mr. Burley died.
Right.
So Mr. Charles, he's in charge of the floor part.
Mm-hmm.
So Mr. Daniel Burley also, he did that work along with athletic director with the buses. So
okay.
I came along and I was hired on to help Coach Watts with Mr. Daniel.
So Burley, you've taken on the mantle.
Taking on the mantle.
All right. Well, we certainly appreciate everything you do, and thank you for showing us how much easier than it was than the old-fashioned way.
Old school.
New school. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Since 1987, Little House Self-Storage has been serving Dublin and Warner Robins with the best in customer service and the lowest prices anywhere. Any shape, any size, we have it, plus climate control. At Little House Self-Storage, safety and security are our top priority. With TV security, special lighting, wide drives for easy access, and 24-hour-a-day access to the storage facility. We invite all businesses to remember Little House Self-Storage for storing records, chip and cookie routes, or contractors. We can even store your car, motorhome, or airplane. Little House Self-Storage, Moody Road, Warner Robins, and Marion Street in Dublin.
Okay, we're here with Mr. Sam. He's going to allow me to do a little work with him today. This is your job every day.
Yes, ma'am.
Is to make sure these rooms are vacuumed.
Right.
Okay. This is a heavy-duty commercial.
First, I got to get up my face, but you know.
So I have to pick up all this trash. All right.
Not the hair, just the big paper.
Oh, just the big thing, nothing small. Okay.
All right.
I've got gloves.
Okay, and I break it down.
Mm-hmm. Just like. I'm used to this. I can do this without a problem. All behind the door. Which windows? Like this one here?
Yeah.
Just what is this anyway? Windex? Is it industrial Windex?
It's kind of a little strong, but I put water to it.
Oh, to kind of, you know.
So it won't be so strong.
So you don't even use paper towels?
Sometimes I do.
Get all in the cracks.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, these windows are so clean. Oh, how's that?
Good.
Oh, that window is like squeaky clean, isn't it?
It's squeaky clean. it's
good. So it's on.
It's on now.
So what do I do?
Okay, you give you some water. You put it about right there.
About right there? Leave it there?
Yeah, leave
okay.
it there.
Okay.
It's got water now.
It says it's about full. All right. Wait! Take my hands off?
Your hands off and then stop.
Oh, like take it off of this. Slow it down. So what is it doing? I gotta actually pull it. It's
going. Scrubbing and then it's sucking it back up.
Oh my goodness. Look how that's. And so this is where you're talking about the kids getting on your floor.
Right.
You do it in a straight line?
Yeah.
I need one of these at the house.
How
long have they been using this equipment? Oh, wow. So look how clean it's getting this floor. Wow. Okay. So when there's food on the floor, though, what do? No. That's awesome. Is that how you gauge it on what you've done?
Uh-huh. Okay, just turn around and go right back.
Wait a minute now. Right here? Is this where you start? Like, is these two lines?
Uh-huh. You'll get the whole floor like that. So.
Oh, and that makes it so much easier when you're able to gauge it like that.
Right.
So you'll know what you've gotten already.
Right on. I tell you what, all these youngers on here, it's hard to keep it looking.
Oh, I'm sure it is. All the way over. And you do have to have teamwork, because if you've got to, like, buff the floor and do all this, and in the lines, right?
Mm-hmm. All you got today.
My back will start hurting after a while. When you come, like with me, I'm short, you know, so I just.
There you go.
Work it like this, huh? And so you're doing this even when kids are in PE class.
I try to get part of it. It's hard to get. I get this part, and at a while, after they leave out about dinner time.
Mm-hmm.
Then I get the rest of it.
Oh, is that right? This floor already looks so clean anyway.
They're doing this floor. Real good job.
It looks great. Oh, there's something. I finally actually see something, and I don't know what it is.